Hi, Seb from Shapr3D here. Thanks for joining us again for another round of product updates. As I hinted in our last video, we've started working on drawings again, and we've just rolled out size tolerances. So here's a simple part which I've modeled in Shapr3D, and I already started to create a simple drawing for this. Let's dive right in, and we'll focus on the side view over here. So we can zoom into this particular dimension here, and adding a tolerance is as simple as clicking on the dimension, and you can either use the badge on the side here or double click on the dimension to open up this menu here. And we can turn tolerances on. We've got a selection of different tolerances available. I'll be selecting deviation. And for this demo, let's just set an upper bound of 0.05 millimeters and hit enter. And it's as simple as that. As you can see, the tolerance is now applied to your drawing. We've also been working on the spline experience within Shapr3D. One of the first things we changed is the experience to create and modify splines on stylus devices, like an iPad or a Windows device with an appropriate stylus. If we take a look at this model here, we've got a handle for a hand drill, and I'll try and show you the new experience by creating a spline here. So in the past, whenever you would add control points, you would need to apply extra pressure to indicate where the control point would be. And instead of doing that, you're now able to continuously draw the necessary line and simply lift the stylus off of the surface and put it back down to continue drawing. So let's try that out here. So I've zoomed in, and we can select spline here and simply start to draw. So we can simply add these necessary segments. And as you can see, we are ensuring that there's a good degree of continuity without needing to think about it too much. So we can just add a few more sections. And should you want to fit that a little bit better, you can see that you can grab onto those control points and modify it as necessary. In addition to this, we have also made it a lot easier to join or to split splines which you've created. To do this, you would simply select a control point, and you can see there's a little badge here on the side which you could use to split. And then if we move that, you can see it's not maintaining continuity, or we can rejoin it and it will ensure a smooth continuity again. And last of all, we've also made it easier to add additional control points for an existing spline. To do that, you would just need to long tap if you're using a stylus, or right click if you're using a mouse on a normal desktop device. In our last video, I also mentioned that we've updated the dimension input to allow you to use different arithmetic operators as a kind of calculator when setting your dimensions. And we've now updated the Numpad as well to basically allow you to do the exact same thing and input basic calculations when you're setting your dimensions. So let's try that out on this part here again. So if I select this, as I showed last time, you could type the arithmetic operations right in here. But if you click on the dimension, we've got this updated Numpad available now. So you could simply type in whatever you like and set it, and you can see the dimension is now up to date. Finally, we've also been working on visualization. As I mentioned in the last video, we've been updating our environments with a focus on making the lighting even smoother with better contrast and better shadows. In addition to the environments we spoke about last time, we've just rolled out one additional environment, which we're calling Dark Salon. In addition to the goals I mentioned, we feel it gives a much nicer, dramatic look to your designs. Let's try and apply that. We'll shift over to the Environment tab in the Visualization environment. And if we scroll all the way down to the bottom, we can apply Dark Salon here. And you can take a nice look at that. Thanks so much for joining me again. I really look forward to seeing all the great designs that you and your teams are able to create with Shapr3D. And I look forward to having you join us again next time. Thanks and bye.